So guys, today we'll be discussing candles and trend lines, and I would like to say this as where East meets West, because candles came from the East, whereas trend lines are a part of a Western tradition. So this is one of the very important videos and very basic concepts that every trader needs to understand, and we will have a total of 5 subtopics. That would be the sloping trend lines, horizontal trend lines, change of polarity, crack and snap, and falling off the roof. These are 5 different tricks, or I would say 5 different basic concepts that every person needs to understand and every person needs to know before trading. So let's start with sloping trend lines. Okay, focusing on here, sloping trend lines, we have 4 pictures. Here we can see there's one in which it says rising support line, and it's the subtitle is higher lows. So basically what is happening, the stock is trading when it's making higher lows, base meaning it's not hitting the same low that it hit before on the second downtrend, and then it keeps showing that. So what we do, we make a trend line by connecting the shadows of the last candlestick over here. So this is the rising support line, and what happens is most often I get the question, what do I connect? Do I connect the body of those candlesticks, meaning the close of those candlesticks, or the shadows or the lower lows of the candlesticks? The answer is that I personally use shadows, and that's what usually most of the other persons do, because that's basically the least down support. That's where the least can go. But you can also connect the close of the bodies, and that would work perfectly fine. But I personally have a preference that I use the shadows of the candlesticks, meaning the lower wicks or the higher wicks. Secondly, we have here is a falling support line. Same topic, just connect the lows or the shadows of the wicks, but this time connecting in a falling support line. Now this can be considered as an uptrend, whereas this is a downtrend. Okay, and what happens that uncharted territory, by uncharted territory I mean that if we go back into the chart, this is the place where it have never traded before, or in a 1 year chart or in a 2 year chart, we can't go back to find the support. And most often people say that if it's not in the 1 year chart, then should we go before time to find the support? And yes, go as far as you want to find the previous support or the previous resistance, because most of the time that helps. That is the place where the stock bounces back. So if you can't find support in a 1 year chart, use this. Go back in time. If you still don't found, then this type of slope line, this and this type of slope line, this type of slope line, the second and fourth, these type of slope lines, and if we extend them, then they act pretty nicely as support lines. So what happens that we connect the lows of the candlesticks, falling, it's a falling support line and it's bearish, but very often when the market hits that support line, it bounces back for a short time of period. So if you want to trade a stock which is in a downtrend and it's in uncharted territory, and if you have the falling support line correctly built, when the stock hits that perfect point on that price, on that line, it usually bounces back. Just like here, it hit this, it bounced back, hit this, bounced back, hit this, bounced back, and this would go on until it doesn't go into the uptrend or until it doesn't change the trend. Here we have falling resistance line. Falling resistance line can be made when we are having lower highs. Like this was higher lows and higher highs, or if it's not even higher highs, it doesn't matter. Here we have lower lows, and here we can see this is lower highs, and here we can see that we have connected the high of the candle, that is the top of the candles over here. So for this we need at least 3 candles, and for this too at least 3 candles, but for this second and fourth, the rising resistance line and falling support line, we can use only 2 troughs and 2 crests, and that would be enough, and we would just extend the line for the future bullish rising resistance line or for the future trend line. So uncharted territory, just the opposite of falling support line, we have the rising resistance line, we have higher highs over here, and when we connect the highs of the candlesticks and we extend the line, rising resistance lines is very bullish. So it is very bullish, but very often market bounces back shortly. So here and here, this line can be acted as a good price targets if you are going short or if we are going long on this one. Here we have two basic examples, very classic textbook examples. This is an example of higher lows in which we have a rising support line, and here you can see whenever the stock has come to this point, it has bounced back pretty well, came to this point and it has bounced back. And here we have a declining support line, or basically a falling resistance line, and here we can see when the stock hit this price in an uncharted territory, it came back down until it broke that trend, and then this became support, which is also called change of polarity, and we will be discussing that in the future slides. Okay, we have a case study over here, and here we can see this is a channel, this is a wedge, and this green area, this is the wedge. The stock is trading in this range. It came down to this, it bounces back, came down, bounces back, came down, bounces back, came down, bounces back, and so on until it goes over there, it touches this high. Now this was a rising support line, right? This is higher highs. This was the rising resistance line. So this was the rising resistance line, and below we have rising support line. Okay, now this is how we have made the trend. Now it's moving in a trend until what happens? Until what happens that this hit this area over here, came back, and this met this area. Now this time it didn't bend all the way up to the green line. It came back down and it touched this. And this would have acted as the previous horizontal resistance lines now, since that was the higher high, and it didn't make the new high of the day. And after that, this was a shooting star over here. We have discussed that before. And after a shooting star here, we saw a evening star, which closed below this area. An evening star is a good resistance or a good bearish reversal signal. But what was the factor here that really triggered it? What happened that this was the previous support and this was the previous support. So this can be called S1 and S2, and this was the first thing that broke. So first we broke the trend, we had an evening star at the top, and then what happened, it didn't bounce back off the support, and once this totally broke, it cracked, retested it. This was, if you were long over here, this was the time where you would have, and if this broke, and if you were long over here, this would have been the time to sell at your entry point over here. Because if you were hoping that this was bounced back over here and it didn't, it came back down, it retested it. And most of the time it happens when a stock broke its resistance and support, it came down, it retested, and that's the time you get out of the trade. No questions asked, just bail out of the trade. Because after that, if it retests and it doesn't break, it's gonna go wildly short. And that's what happened over here. We had both the Eastern signals, that was the candlestick, the Western signal, which was the trend line, and that's how we merged both the signals over here, the Eastern signals and as well as the Western signals. So once we merge all these signals, we have a higher probability of making our trades work over here. Okay, so now we'll be discussing horizontal support and resistance line, and why it's important. It's important because most of the time, and most of the people, and usually everyone looks at it. So what's why we need to understand this? Because in a stock market, you need to look what others are looking, you need to know what others have, what others are seeing. Because if they have the same resistance and support line as you have, then they would be exiting or initiating new positions at the same levels. So if you have these things wrong, make sure that you study properly, you do your research, you make your trend lines, you make your resistance lines as accurately as possible, because that's gonna increase your chances of winning the trade. Here we can see this was a bullish, bearish engulfing pattern. Just once. Okay, here we can see this was the bearish engulfing pattern over here, a more like a dark cloud cover, and we know the dark cloud cover top acts as a resistance. So we have made a resistance lines over here, and then this was the highest NHOD, new high of the day or new high of the swing or new high of the week. So this would have become the resistance, second resistance. So what happens after that the price came back down, and here we had some resistance over here. So I made a line over here. This was the R1, first resistance, and this was the R2, second resistance. So what we can do that sometimes we use the candlesticks such as hammer, shooting star. This was a shooting star and it confirmed our resistance area. Shooting star was being formed at the resistance area. Okay, and dark cloud cover was being formed at the resistance area. So what happened, this was the time to go short or to quit your long positions because it was showing signs of weakness over here. And after that it gapped down, this became, why did I make these lines as my new resistance area? Because when this window, this was a window, and we know windows, a falling window is a good resistance line or good resistance, and a rising window is a good support line. So that's why I made these two lines over here, because this was the gap over here, this became the first resistance area, and since this held pretty well over here, if you can see, the stock retested these resistances and came back down. Okay, here we can see this is a morning star. So this would, the low of this candle would have been our support line. We held this, and what happened after that? After the morning star, that was a good reversal signal, went crazy, stock went crazy over here. Here we see a bull bearish engulfing pattern after a doji. The stock came back, went back up, and look what happened here. What happened after that? It came back down to this area. It was, this area was the new support and the price went back up. So it doesn't matter how old your support is. If that support is support, and resistance is resistance. It will always be there. And once support changes, it becomes resistance. And once resistance changes, it becomes support. So make sure you understand. Make sure you have your resistance and support lines drawn on each of your charts, each of your watchlist tickers, and be very accurate in drawing them. Okay, what happened here? Here we have a chart, it goes back up. This was the first resistance area. I could say this is the second resistance area. It came back down. We have a long wick doji or higher wick candlestick. We make that as our first resistance. That is the second resistance. The stock fall down. This is a window. Since in that window we have two, this acted as our new resistance area because this is a falling window. The stock went up and it gapped up. It broke this resistance. Once this resistance broke, this is not any good resistance anymore. It gapped up. This would have become new support area. It went back to the previous resistance area and it came back down. So resistance always held, support always held. Whether it's a trend, sloping trend line, it doesn't matter. Here again, you can see, guys, we have a support down here, we have resistance down here, it came back down to support, it moved back up. This is our long wick candlestick, we make that as our resistance. It held pretty well. Here again we have a long wick candlestick, this act as resistance. So basically what happens is that we usually see previous price action, and on the basis of that previous price action we draw our horizontal support and resistance lines, because that's where the people are gonna exit their position. That's where we are gonna see a reversal sign, most of them. Okay, now we talk about change of polarity. So when support becomes resistance and resistance becomes support, that is called change of polarity. So first we have a stock, it's moving in a trend, it moving in a range, it held the support, bounces back, held the support, bounces back, held the support, bounces back, and then it doesn't hold the support and it broke that support. So what happens, that then that support becomes resistance. So that is called change of polarity, and same goes with the resistance. The previous resistance becomes new support. So how can we use this change of polarity? So here you can see how the old support becomes new resistance. This is applicable for both swing and day trading, and obviously long term trading. So this was the support, the price came back down. This is more like a hammer or a doji over here. It bounced back, touched this support, bounced back, came back to this support, didn't hold this support. Now this support becomes resistance over here. Went back up, tested the resistance, came back down. Went back up, tested the resistance, came back down. And that's what basically change of polarity is. So you need to understand that the previous resistance becomes new support. So once you have support and resistance lines set up on a chart, you don't have to make new support or resistance lines when it breaks the trend, because then that would be your new support or new resistance. here you can see more accurately what happens. This is the support, stock is holding the support, it broke the support. Now this becomes resistance over here. Now stock is retesting it, broke this, now it becomes support. So that is the change of polarity, and that is one of the most important things we need to understand before starting our trades. Okay, here what happens? Here what happens, guys? Here we have a support line. It is holding pretty well. This is more like a hammer. So this would be my actual support line over here. Let me draw this over here for you guys. So this is a more accurate support for me, and let's continue. So this black line was the support area for me. It came back this to this area, it bounced back from here, it went back up, tested the support. Now this, what is this? This is a piercing pattern, which is a reversal signal. Reversal signal forming at support, the stock bounced back, came back down. Now this was the support resistance area. It became support at here, it bounced back from here. This broke the support. Now this area became resistance again. It came back down to this support. This support was forming a piercing pattern, another reversal signal. But now we know resistance is over here. So that is not a good trade, because if you are buying here and selling over here, that would be a conservative resistance, and it held pretty well, because since its test is 1, 2, and 3 time now, it came back down, it broke this resistance. Now this becomes support again. It went back up, came here, got some support. Support didn't help. This becomes resistance now. It came back down, and then it went back up, came back down. See if this makes any sense to you guys. Let me show it to you over here. So if to be very accurate here, so this acted as a good support and resistance area also. The stock came, went back up, this became resistance, support, resistance, broke resistance, this becomes support, held support, where bounced back, broke the support, this is new support now, resistance, had some resistance, came down, broke this resistance, now this is support, here again it held some support over here, broke this, then again it went up, down, up, down, broke, broke. Now this become our new support. But what happens here? Okay, the first, second, and third piercing patterns, 1, 2, and 3, we would have initiated a long position, but not on the fourth piercing pattern. And why is that? So what happens is, guys, now this is a reversal signal over here, but now this, just above that, we have resistance area. So now we have a reversal signal, the stock is in downtrend and everything, but we didn't took a long position because we know that just above our candlestick we have resistance, then that would be our first price target, so that wouldn't be a good trade. Okay, coming on to crack and snap. Now crack and snap is when support or resistance breaks and then comes back up, is called crack and snap. So what happens that the stock breaks its support and bounces back. It broke its support and bounces back. That's a crack and snap. So the good thing about crack and snap is that we can have a price target for it. So basically, if you can see here in the diagram, this is the price target. If this cracked and snapped, we would have bought above the support area, and our first price target would be this area or somewhere around that. Okay, so here you can see this is our price target. The stock cracked, snapped back up. We bought at this area 135 and at 13500 to 13800. So that's S dot shield, and it's a very old chart, 15 minutes. Here you can see what happened, guys. This was the support. Support broke, cracked, and snapped. So more like a false breakout over here and snap, and then it just boom. So basically this is a very good thing. If a stock broke its support and then cracked back up, now crack and snap could take 2 sessions, 3 sessions, or 4 sessions, but it doesn't take any longer than 5 sessions. So because what happens is that there could be 1 candlestick, 2 candlestick, 3 candlestick, 4 candlestick, and boom. So 5 candlestick is okay, 3 candlestick is okay, but more than that, then most possibly it's not gonna break that support again. So once it broke support, breaks that resistance area and comes back up, that's the time to buy, and our first price target would be very conservative at the high of this area. On that way up, you should be scaling profits. Here again, this was the target area, broke this resist support, came back up, and boom. The quicker it comes back up to the support area, the better Kraken Snap it is. Okay, it's more like now we discussed in our first slide, falling off the roof, which is basically the opposite of Kraken Snap, and it is also considered as a false breakout over here. So I put in the heading of false breakout. Now, false breakout is the opposite of the Kraken Snap, and that is the false breakout. So what happens again in Kraken Snap and false breakout, we have a price target over here. The stock breaks the uptrend, the stock breaks the resistance, but cracked back down, and that's where we go short on this stock. Because it's just the opposite, this would be our price target and it definitely hit over here. Now we have an example of East and West together. Up till now we have studied candlesticks and everything. Now we are going to put all the things together. So what happens here is, guys, this is the support area. The stock came down. We see a bullish engulfing pattern here. This became our support. It goes up from here, bounced back to this area. And at this area, what happens? At this area, it cracks this support. But it doesn't help this area. The next session opened up pretty well over here. Now that is a crack and snap. So crack and snap, our first price target would be here. Or this would be a resistance area over here. So conservative resistance area would be this. So if we buy this here, we sell some here, and the next resistance was there. So we sell some here, and then our next resistance, our next price target would be there. So basically what happened, this is more like a bullish engulfing pattern, more like a hammer or piercing pattern. And see, so mixing candlesticks with resistance and West is a really good way to make sure that your charts, your trades are gonna work perfectly fine.